As a developer or infrastructure engineer, how many times have you faced this scenario where you need temporary access to a production system, but your organization's access control is all or nothing? You either have permanent access, permanently, creating security risks, or no access at all, which blocks your work. This is exactly the problem that Tailscale's new just-in-time access feature solves. JIT, or just-in-time access, provides temporary, task-specific permissions to resources in your Tailscale network. We call that a Tailnet. Instead of permanent privileges, team members receive exactly what they need only for the time required to complete their tasks. So when the time expires, access is automatically revoked. So who is JIT access for? Well, we think it's perfect for DevOps teams managing production infrastructure, security-conscious organizations wanting to limit standing permissions, and companies with strict compliance requirements. It's also ideal for managing contractors or temporary workers who need limited access, or for protecting critical systems like Kubernetes clusters and production databases. Essentially, if you have sensitive resources that should only be accessed when necessary, JIT access provides the security controls you need whilst maintaining productivity. At its core, JIT access temporarily modifies your Tailnet's access control lists, or ACLs. These policies define who can access what and are evaluated in real time when connections are attempted. JIT evaluates multiple attributes when determining if a connection should be permitted. Things like device posture, software versions, and geographic locations are all checked in real time against policy. These policy modifications, though, aren't permanent. They only exist for the duration of the window of time that you request. So let's say, for example, you've got a maintenance window. That connection will only be permitted by the JIT access rules during that specific time frame. This works because Tailscale's control plane dynamically evaluates each connection based on your baseline access rules plus any active JIT attributes for a specific device. The result is that policies adapt to the specific moment they're needed. Tailscale's JIT access management is only available on our enterprise plan. But if you're interested in implementing JIT, you can visit tailscale.com/sales and have one of our team reach out to you to help you to discuss your needs. Well, I'm joined by Alan, who's one of our solutions engineers here at Tailscale. He is our resident JIT expert, and I've rigged him up to do us a quick demo of JIT today.
Thank you, Alex. And today what we're going to showcase the Tailscale just-in-time demo using Slack. This is available on GitHub and open source for you to utilize. So in this case, let me kind of walk you through. I've got an admin page here with my one user signed in to my Tailnet. My client is signed in here as my client that I'm going to demo access with. And you can see I have a page here called Demo Streamer that shows me as not connected. So it says, sorry, Alan, you're on the Tailnet, but you don't have access to this device itself. And I can verify that by looking at my client, my Tailscale status. You notice there is no server named Demo Streamer or anything along that line. And I can even look at my client here and look at network devices, and it does not show up here. I do have app connectors and extent nodes, subnet routers, because those are in our demo environment set up for everybody to utilize. So now I'm Alan at Outlook, and I need access to this production server to do some work. So I'm gonna ask my boss, Alex, over here to approve this. But first of all, I need to fire off a workflow. So with the Slack integration, I'm gonna fire it off. It's gonna open up a pop-up here in a minute, and I'm going to choose the just-in-time Tailscale demo system. I'm gonna choose which device. It takes a little bit. This is my MacBook today that I'm gonna sign in as. And for 5 minutes, and I'm gonna have my boss, Mr. Alex, approve it. Need to troubleshoot something. So I'm going to fire off a message. Now Alex is going to get a notification on your side of Slack.
Yep, I see that come in right away. So if I go down to this app down here, JIT Tailscale Access Bot, you can see I've got the tag being requested by Alan, the user. He's requesting a 5-minute access to the resource Alan V Outlook MacBook Pro.ts. justworks.net. So I'm going to click on the big green approve button, and hopefully you'll see that come through.
There it is. Alan's request has approved. And I can verify this with the Tailscale configuration logs. Oh, and look, traffic is starting to flow on the right-hand side. So now as an end user, nothing I really had to do. I just requested temporary access. Tailscale logs that. You can see here where it makes an update using, that was from our earlier one, our node attributes, and says, hey, let's give Alan access. From a command line, I now see this new device called Demo Streamer. I'm able to connect to it. And I can even SSH into this box or access it based on whatever Tailscale ACLs. In this instance, I have it set up to access all the ports, but in your environment, you can set up saying, hey, we only want to allow access to a web-based app, a web port, 80443, or maybe SSH or any other custom port along that line. And the cool thing about this, within 5 minutes, this access will automatically be revoked, nothing I have to do. So if you have this integrated in a ticketing system or you want to grant somebody that just-in-time access quickly, this is how one way that you can do that for sure.
Tailscale provides several ways to implement JIT access. The first, as I mentioned, are device posture attributes. These are key value pairs attached to devices that can be used within your Tailnet policy to determine access permissions. Third-party integrations are also another option as well. So Tailscale partners with companies like Slack, GitHub, Opal, ConductorOne, and Sim to provide seamless JIT access as well. Tailscale also has a very well-featured API, so if you want to write a custom implementation for your business, you can use the Tailscale API to programmatically manage policy files for JIT access. And finally, we also do group membership syncing as well, so you can manage access based on group membership by syncing groups from your identity provider directly to Tailscale. All of these approaches work with your access control policies to provide the right level of access for the right duration. Here are some of the key benefits of JIT access. You can secure temporary access by granting users task-specific permissions for only the required duration of the task they need to complete. You can also protect critical production infrastructure, including individual machines, groups of machines using tags, and Kubernetes clusters as well, using our Tailscale Kubernetes operator. You can also leverage seamless automation by integrating with tools like Slack and GitHub Actions, or dedicated access management platforms as well. So, as we've seen, Tailscale's JIT access provides a powerful yet user-friendly way to securely manage access to your most critical resources. By placing standing permissions with temporary task-specific access, you can dramatically improve your security posture whilst maintaining productivity. If you'd like to find out more about how you can bring Tailscale to work, then head on over to tailscale.com/btw and join over 10,000 other paying companies who have already made the switch to Tailscale. As always, thank you so much for watching, and until next time, I've been Alex from Tailscale.